Well, hello there, all you malty mega pioneers of maltiness. Ralphie here with Whisky Review 164. And part of the almost concluding, but not quite, the season on American spirits. There's one more to go that hasn't been mentioned yet, but I'm keeping that as a bit of a surprise for next review. In the meantime, rye. Why rye? Simple, because it is a very flavoursome grain. If you haven't tasted rye, it's rather easy to do. You go into your supermarket, your delicatessen, and you look for that German bread. It's a kind of rectangular shape. And it says German rye bread. It's very dense, quite heavy, and it keeps very well because that is the nature of the rye grain. It's a tough grain. It grows in poor soil. It grows in inclement conditions. And it is ideal for planting around the arable crops if you're a pioneer. And then first of all, you can make beer out of it, and then you can distill it, and you have something of a medicinal nature to help you through these harsh prairie winters. So if you watch the cowboy films, by the way, and they go into the bar and it's a wee tiny glass, wee heavy duty glass, for the simple reason small heavy glasses don't break so easily in a place where it's hard to get glasses. They'd fill it up to the brim with the rye whiskey, they'd slap down their dimes and then they'd knock it back in a winner. What they were knocking back was rough young rye, but it pressed the button, it did the trick. So with the kind of tough lives that cowboys, you know, had to endure in the early years, driving the herds of cattle north from the southern states into the north, where things were getting more industrial, the bigger demand for beef. I recommend you read past the Western movies, the John Wayne movies, which give you a certain kind of perspective, a glamorized perspective, and you read the actual history of just how tough things were for the cowboys were, where they were more likely to be killed in a night stampede, trampled to death under the hooves of panicked steers, than they were to be shot in the local barroom brawl. But there we have it, back to rye. Rye and corn are two very interesting versions of American spirits. I've not really tackled a 100% corn whiskey with this review series, but I will in the next one. But I'm certainly going to tackle rye. This is Rittenhouse Rye. It's 100 degrees proof. Extra strength should mean extra flavour, and we do like that. If you like peaty Scotch whiskies from Islay, with their demanding flavours, from the likes of Laphroaig and Ardbeg and Lagavulin. If you love big flavoured stuff, then you will enjoy rye whiskey. From Whistle Pig, which is a small artisan, extremely well-crafted rye, to the hugely popular Wild Turkey range of ryes. Which tend to be the most out there, particularly in the United States. But I'm picking Rittenhouse because Rittenhouse is a kind of refined rye. It's a more subtle rye. It has the intensity, but it has refinement with it. So it's a little bit of a rye with a difference. Rye, by the way, it's all about the way it's done. When you're making rye whiskey, you can either just take the mashed grains, cooked grains, straight into fermentation, into the still, but you can't beat experience. And in getting different versions of rye, it's all down to just the way it's processed and the way the proportion of rye in the rye, because ryes do not have to be 100% rye grain, although if they are not, they should state it in the label. Respect the integrity of the consumer by maintaining their own integrity. Yes. Tasting notes. Rittenhouse, good version, here we go. Surprisingly soft on the nose. It's a subtle one for all its strength. You could easily drink this neat. Spiced maple-y rye. It's got a lovely, sweet, softer version. Nuttiness, hazelnuts, pecans. There's a real maple weave, maple thread running backwards and forwards through this rye. The rye itself has a complexity and a delicacy as well. On the nose, excellent stuff. There's no edginess, no coarse bitterness in the nose. The hazelnut, the wood, there's ash and there's dark toffee and a touch of treacle toffee about it. Now I'm actually, for 100 proof, I'm not going to add much water. It doesn't need it. A couple of spoons with my universal unit of measurement. There we go. While I'm nosing this, and before I read out my notes, I'm going to recommend two more online resources for finding out more about American spirits. The first one is... what is it? Excuse me a second. I'm glad I write things down. Straightbourbon.com. All one word, straight bourbon. It's a forum and it gives you some advice. And guys, go on there, have a chat about it, make recommendations. Forums are always good places to hang out before you spend large sums of cash. Get the knowledge. And the other one is Sour Mash Manifesto. Bit of a long word that. It's three words put together. SourMashManifesto.com, which is Jason's vlogs. Yes, Jason is doing kind of the same as what I'm doing, but he's concentrating on American spirits. He is articulate. He knows what he's talking about. I recommend Jason's stuff. Just Google it. You'll find it. Alternatively, go to Whiskey Stuff or Whiskey Reviews at Ralphie.com and follow my links. The nose. The taste. No, I've done the nosing. It's the taste now. With rye, it's all about what happens after the arrival. The rival itself has got a little bit of cider vinegar. It suddenly builds up in intensity, partly to do with the strength. I think I'll add a bit more water actually, I'll just pour it in. I'm not going to go, it comes with, the water you put in whiskey comes with experience, personal experience. Steady, sweet, spicy rye arrival, fruity, nutty, oaky, and well balanced, very sustained in its development. Excellent stuff. Water smoothens it out a little bit and it adds a touch of pickled ginger. Sour ginger. Quite complex, and a little bit of chili heat, and the finish is maple, oak and spice. And you add all up and you get 87 out of 100, and that, Bourbon Buddies, or Rye Rascals, is a rye mark. There we go. I love rye. Put a drop, if you get any absinthe, get a straw, a drop, one drop, maybe two if it's a bigger measure, into your rye and create a concentrated Sazerac. Go for it. Ralphie.com. I'll go and get myself a cup of tea now. Yes. Thanks for watching. See you soon. Bye-bye.